To find the side length of each of these squares, we actually took the square root of each of the areas. We can rewrite 4 as 2 squared, so we have the square root of 2 squared. This square root undoes the square power, leaving us with just 2. The same thing happens for the square root of 25. We rewrite 25 as 5 squared, and then we take the square root of 5 squared, which equals 5. And the same is true for this third case. We have the square root of 81, which gives us 9. This symbol is called a radical, and all three of these radicals are actually square roots. It's likely that you've seen these before, but you might not have known there's an index of 2 here. The index indicates the root we are taking, since we don't always have to take a square root. We'll see other types of roots later, but for now, just know that all square roots have an index of 2, but it's really rare that you'll ever see it written. You'll usually just see it like this. This is a list of some perfect squares that you'll run into often. You want to make sure that you're comfortable recognizing these perfect squares, since they help us simplify radicals. Remember, this is the radical symbol, and in this case, the index is a 2, so we have a square root. We don't list the 2 for square roots, but we know it's there.